You may be asking yourself, where should I be looking in the Triangle region of North Carolina if my budget is X? Well, that's a question I get all the time by people looking to move to the region, but who aren't sure where their money will take them. About a year ago, I made a video of the top 20 cities from most expensive to least, but a lot changes in a year, so I wanted to give it a little update. And don't worry, I won't bore y'all with a full list of 20 this time. Instead, today we're gonna look at the top 5 most expensive and top 5 most affordable cities and suburbs of the Triangle region of North Carolina. But before we dive in, my name is Matt Martin and I'm a Raleigh-based realtor. I've helped tons of clients, just like you, relocate to the Triangle region of North Carolina. And if you're looking to do the same, I'd love to help you too. Now, even though I'm paring down this video, you can still get a look at the entire list of cities here. I'm just not gonna discuss them all. While you're perusing that, a quick disclaimer. For this video, I looked exclusively at detached single-family homes, but I'm happy to break down townhomes or condos if you're interested. Just leave me a comment down below. Out of the over 5,000 closed sales over the last 3 months, these 24 cities and regions had median sales prices ranging from $360,000 to $799,000, and a median of just 12 days on the market. So if you're ready for the nitty-gritty, let's dive in. Let's start with the most expensive, Chapel Hill, with single family homes ranging from $100,000 to $3.95 million. Chapel Hill had a median single family home price of $799,000 and a median home size of 2,800 square feet that sold in about 9 days. Chapel Hill is one of the core three cities of the Triangle, and drawing an imaginary line between it, Durham, and Raleigh gives you the triangle shape from which the area derives its name. Chapel Hill is home to UNC Chapel Hill, which lends to the very college feel of its super cute downtown along Franklin Street. The area is known for its gorgeous mid-century modern architecture, abundance of trees and nature, and many classic homes dating back 100 years or more. It's located about 20 to 25 minutes from the Research Triangle Park and downtown Durham, and about 40 minutes from downtown Raleigh. Next up, we have Apex, with single family homes ranging from $285,000 to $2.85 million. Apex had a median single family home price of $730,000 and a median home size of just over 2,800 square feet that sold in about 6 days. Apex is located southwest of Raleigh and has seen tremendous growth in the last few years, with new subdivisions juxtaposed against the super quaint historic downtown along Salem Street. Apex is bordered by I-540 to its west and has easy access to highways 1 and 64, making it a short drive to RTP and RDU in just under 20 minutes, downtown Raleigh in 20 to 25 minutes, and downtown Durham in 25 to 30 minutes. And New York developer RXR recently labeled Apex as a superstar region and announced plans for its $3 billion first phase of Viridia, which will ultimately become a 1,000-acre mixed-use development with multiple types of housing, commercial space, greenways, amenities, and even a college campus. At number 3, we have a combo region consisting of New Hill and Moncur, with single-family homes ranging from $160,000 to $1.7 million. The New Hill-Moncur area had a median single-family home price of $725,000 and a median home size of over 2,900 square feet that sold in about 9 days. New Hill's high median sales price is mainly driven by new communities that have been popping up recently as the Triangle continues to expand its borders outward. New Hill is a bit further south, about 20 to 25 minutes from RTP, 25 to 30 minutes from downtown Raleigh, and 30 to 35 minutes from downtown Durham. But it's conveniently located just south of I-540, which is undergoing a massive expansion right now. So this area of town has seen a ton of growth recently. It's also not far from Jordan Lake, which allows motorized boats and provides a great respite from the summertime heat. At number 4, we have Cary, with single-family homes ranging from $360,000 to $3.8 million, Carrie had a median single-family home price of $715,000 and a median home size of 2,700 square feet that sold in about 5 days. Carrie is incredibly conveniently located, just 20 to 25 minutes southeast of downtown Durham, 15 to 20 minutes west of downtown Raleigh, and 15 minutes south of RTP and RDU Airport. Pair that with great public schools, great access to the outdoors, and one of the region's best downtowns, it's no surprise that Carrie homes are high in demand, and Carrie prices to match. Pun fully intended. You can check out my videos on the most expensive neighborhoods in Cary and the pros and cons of Cary, which I'll link in the description below if you want to learn more. And the number 5 most expensive community in the Triangle is Holly Springs. With single family homes ranging from $260,000 to $1.7 million, Holly Springs had a median single family home price of $675,000 and a median home size of nearly 2,900 square feet that sold in about 8 days. Holly Springs is located about 25 minutes southwest of downtown Raleigh, just outside the I-540 outer beltline, which, as I mentioned before, is undergoing a massive expansion right now that's expected to open any day now. This, by the way, is being filmed in late 2024 and will eventually create a second loop around Raleigh. Because of the added convenience and accessibility that this freeway expansion will bring, nearby communities have seen explosive growth. Not only has Holly Springs built up its downtown quite a bit in recent years to bring new restaurants and amenities to its residents, but it's also positioned itself as a global biomanufacturing hub with mega life sciences companies like Fujifilm, CSL Seqirus, and Amgen all investing heavily there. I made a whole video about the pros and cons of Holly Springs that I'll link in the description below. Rounding out the top 10, we have Pittsboro, Carrboro, Morrisville, Hillsboro, and Wake Forest. Now, on to the most affordable suburbs of the Triangle region, starting with the most expensive of the 5 and working our way to the least. At number 5, we have a combination of Efland and Mebane, with single family homes ranging from $135,000 to just over $1 million. The Efland Mebane region had a median single family home price of $405,000 and a median home size of just over 2,000 square feet that sold in about 15 days. Now, I didn't include this region in my last video because it's a little further away, but it still falls within that 30-mile radius of RTP and is growing like crazy as more people are migrating outward to find better value. You're gonna be west of most everything here, which means you can get to the mountains quite a bit faster, and you'll find yourself about 25 to 30 minutes from downtown Durham, about 35 to 40 minutes to RTP and RDU, and upwards of an hour from downtown Raleigh. Mebane has a cute downtown and super easy accessibility to neighboring Hillsboro, the Eno River State Park, and most importantly, the Tanger Outlet Mall. At number 4, we have Clayton and Archer Lodge. With single family homes ranging from $220,000 to $1.15 million, Clayton and Archer Lodge had a median single family home price of $392,000 and a median home size of 2,100 square feet that sold in about 20 days. This is the southeasternmost part of the Triangle and is undergoing incredible amounts of growth. Here, you'll find everything from rural farms to brand new subdivisions, and things are changing every day as new communities are going up. Coming in 2025 will be the North Waterfront District, which will be a large development consisting of waterfront restaurants, a tavern, hotel, condos, and other mixed-use locations. You can find a whole video I made about Clayton linked in the description below. Next up, we have a region I'm dubbing North of Durham, which includes communities like Bahama, Creedmoor, and Hurdle Mills. With single family homes ranging from $170,000 to $1.7 million, this North of Durham region had a median single family home price of $376,000 and a median home size of just under 1,800 square feet that sold in about 16 days. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with y'all. Many people from North Carolina don't even know where these communities are, so don't feel bad if you've never heard of them or if you didn't know that it's pronounced Bahama and not Bahama. If you're looking to get more out into the country with room for a stable and some horses, this area is for you. You're only about 15 minutes north of Durham, but getting to the region's other hot spots will take a bit longer. RTP and RDU are about 30 to 40 minutes away, while downtown Raleigh is almost an hour away. Next up, we have Zebulon, with single family homes ranging from $150,000 to $865,000. Zebulon had a median single family home price of $365,000 and a median home size of nearly 2,000 square feet that sold in about 29 days. Zebulon is the easternmost city on the list and is on the easternmost edge of Wake County, but it's still only about a 25 to 30 minute drive from downtown Raleigh. That said, because it's so far east, it's not the best option for those who work in RTP or Durham. Zebulon is pretty tiny, with a population of only about 8,000 people. So if you're looking for a small town feel with super friendly people and bigger city access, this could be a great option for you. The public schools are highly rated, receiving an A on niche.com, and there are multiple great parks. And while the downtown is cute with its own bourbon distillery, there aren't a ton of big box options here. You'll find those further west in Wendell, Knightdale, or of course, Raleigh. And finally, we have the region's most affordable suburb, Anger. With single family homes ranging from $185,000 to $870,000, Anger had a median single family home price of $360,000 and a median home size of over 2,100 square feet that sold in about 39 days. The tiny 3-square-mile town of Anger, which is the southernmost community on this list, is located about 21 miles south of downtown Raleigh. And while it's currently not the most convenient location for those commuting to RTP for work, it's gonna benefit tremendously from the opening of the I-540 expansion later this year. This will dramatically reduce drive times to the airport, Durham, and RTP, all of which explain why the area has seen such tremendous growth. Anger is known as the town of crepe myrtles, which is my absolute favorite tree in the Carolinas, and it hosts the annual Crepe Myrtle Festival every year, which draws about 20,000 visitors to the community. This will have a more rural feel, but its affordability has driven a ton of growth. Phew, we made it through the Triangle's top 5 most expensive and top 5 most affordable communities. As you can see, there are so many different types of communities that make up the Triangle with a huge range in price points. So there's a little something for everyone. So which one stands out to you? Let me know in the comments below. And if you're ready to kick off your home hunt here in the Triangle, I'd love to be your guide. You can reach me by phone, email, or text, and you can find all my contact information in the link below or by scanning this QR code right here with your phone. And if you like this video, be sure to check out my whole collection of others all about moving to, living in, and buying real estate in the Triangle region of North Carolina. In fact, here's one right here that you might like, so give it a click to keep on watching.